How would you define the stage of the development of the entrepreneurship ecosystem in Bulgaria right now?
I'm really happy with how things are developing. We are really experiencing, I think, exponential improvement. As I mentioned, the level of knowledge and professionalism these days is really impressive. The sense of community and readiness to share your experience is also very high. So people really open, talk to each other, share knowledge and trying to be collectively more successful rather than fighting with each other, because they're not really competitors, besides competing for talent, but that will always be the case. But then I think we are also little by little putting together all the necessary elements for a really vibrant community. You know, you have great startups, some with already pretty impressive levels, funding levels, or even exits. We have a great deal of venture funds. We have international venture funds, including American ones, some of the best ones, already looking into Bulgaria, working with companies here. You have, you know, physical spaces, co-working spaces, clubs. You have specialized media, etc. So educational programs towards entrepreneurship, technology, etc. So all those elements are important so that the magic happens. And you know, 10 years ago we had like two of those, and then another one was added. And these days I think we have no excuse for not being successful, because we have a very, very good fundament. Of course, there are some aspects which require more fundamental, I guess, changes or evolution of the country and the society. One such aspect, of course, is the evolution of the educational system. You know, I'm fully aware and not delusional that this is a complex system that takes time to evolve and change. But we've seen examples globally that if this is a really key governmental policy, it could be done. Mm. It's been done in Singapore and in many, many other countries. So really, Bulgaria as a country has a handful, not too many areas where it has some true competitive differentiation on a regional and even global level. And we should really invest efforts and resources in those directions rather than trying to be better at other things that we can never be. I think, you know, the tech ecosystem and the entrepreneurial ecosystem has never been really a focal point of the government, you know. We all know the eyeballs and the money were elsewhere. The legal framework also was not really supporting what's happening and what can really become a powertrain for Bulgaria. So what I want to see further as a supporting fundament for our startup ecosystem is more bold, evolution and changes in the educational system. We already talked about this. And then more systematic support and understanding and dialogue between the government and the stakeholders here, because we think that, you know, with the support of the government, we can see, you know, the ecosystem get on another level. Mm. It's amazing to see the work of the BESCO, the Startup Association. It's another element that was lacking a few years ago. Now we have even that. So they're doing an amazing job exactly in policy making, in educating political parties, ministries, the government, empowerment as to what are the pain points and what should be passed as a legal framework so that not so much that we are at an advantage, but to eliminate some disadvantages that we currently have and which are putting us sort of in a not so favorable position compared even to some of our neighbors, compared even to some neighbors which are not in the EU. For example, some of the some elements of the legal framework is in Serbia is much better than ours.
And if you're just as passionate about innovation as we are, hit subscribe for the Recursive Podcast on YouTube or your favorite podcast platform. We're everywhere.